Hello everyone, you're watching the Planet Earth channel, and today we're going to talk about the Indian Ocean. What do we know about it? Probably that it's located next to India, and that's true, that the island of Madagascar lies in its waters. By the way, the fourth largest island in the world. Many have heard that not so long ago the most destructive tsunami occurred there, and you'd be right about that too. And many have heard of the beautiful Maldives, and some have even been there. And yes, that's also the Indian Ocean. So not that much information really, so let's find out more about this amazing and massive feature on planet Earth. Together, let's go. The Indian Ocean, the most of the most. It contains the largest bay in the world, the Bay of Bengal, the largest peninsula on the planet, the Arabian Peninsula, the longest strait in the world, the Mozambique Channel, 1,760 kilometers long, the saltiest sea in the world, the Red Sea, salinity 42 parts per thousand. The Republic of Madagascar is the largest country in the world that occupies a single island. And Java Island is the most populated island on the planet. The Indian Ocean ranks third in size, 76.17 million square kilometers, and covers about 20% of Earth's water surface. The area of the Indian Ocean is 10 times larger than the area of all of Australia. And if you like comparisons, the Indian Ocean is big enough to fit 5 Russias, or 8 USAs, or the same number of Chinas, or Canadas, or 575 Greeces, or 1,840 Switzerlands. Its volume is approximately 12,000 times greater than the volume of Lake Baikal, the largest freshwater body on Earth. Between the southern points of Australia and Africa, the width of the Indian Ocean reaches about 10,000 kilometers. This ocean washes the shores of 4 continents, all except North and South America. It is located entirely in the Eastern Hemisphere, and most of it lies south of the equator, meaning in the southern hemisphere. The conventional boundary between the Indian and Atlantic Oceans runs along the 20th meridian, which goes from Cape Agulhas to the Antarctic coast, while the boundary with the Pacific Ocean follows the 147th meridian, linking Tasmania with Antarctica. By the way, a quick note, a meridian is a line formed by slicing the surface of the Earth with a plane that passes through any point on the Earth's surface and the axis of Earth's rotation. There are only 10 marginal seas in the Indian Ocean. Of these, only one is inland, the Red Sea. There are sizable gulfs, the Bay of Bengal and the Great Australian Bight. And these gulfs are so vast that their area rivals that of entire seas. Many people know that the Red Sea is the saltiest sea in the world. Let's not count the Dead Sea, which strictly speaking is not a sea but a landlocked lake. The Red Sea, into which not a single river flows, would have dried up if it weren't replenished by the waters of the Indian Ocean. The waters of the Indian Ocean wash the shores of 39 independent countries and dependent territories of France and the UK. The ocean includes continental islands, Madagascar and Sri Lanka. Some islands are peaks of underwater volcanoes, such as Kerguelen, Réunion and Mauritius. In the equatorial and tropical zones of the ocean, there are many coral islands, the Lakshadweep, Cocos and Andaman Islands, and of course the Maldives, which are also coral islands. The Indian Ocean got its name from India, and India in turn got its name from the Iranians or Persians. The ancient Greeks called it the Erythraean Sea. Primitive humans were crossing the Indian Ocean 40 to 50,000 years ago. Apparently, that's how the first settlers reached Australia from Asia. The shores of the Indian Ocean are home to the settlement areas of some of the oldest peoples and earliest river civilizations. For example, Mesopotamia, in the valleys of the Tigris and Euphrates rivers on the territory of modern Iraq, and the Harappan civilization on the banks of the Indus River. In the late 13th century, the Venetian traveler Marco Polo, on his way back from China, traveled across the Indian Ocean from the Strait of Malacca to the Strait of Hormuz. Marco Polo became the first European to cross it. In the late 15th century, a Portuguese expedition led by Vasco da Gama entered the waters of the Indian Ocean off the East African coast. The expedition crossed the Indian Ocean and reached the Indian subcontinent, or the shores of India. Thus, the sea route to India was opened. In 1642, Dutch navigator Abel Tasman explored the central part of the Indian Ocean. In 1772, British navigator James Cook entered the southern Indian Ocean and approached the western coast of Australia. The Indian Ocean is relatively young, much younger than many of the mountains on our planet. Scientists have established that it formed about 120 to 140 million years ago, when the supercontinent Gondwana split apart, and its pieces, which became individual continents, began to drift in different directions. The bottom relief of the Indian Ocean is complex and diverse. This is due to the location of the ocean at the junction of three major lithospheric plates, the African, Indo-Australian, and Antarctic. Mid-ocean ridges pass through the ocean basin, along the boundaries of these plates. These parts of the ocean are characterized by seismic activity and volcanism, as well as the presence of rift zones and transformed faults. Between the ridges lie deep sea basins. The maximum depth of the Indian Ocean is recorded in the Sunda Trench, 7,729 meters. This trench, located on the boundary of the Indian and Pacific Oceans, is part of the Pacific Ring of Fire, and therefore a zone of active earthquakes and underwater volcanism. The temperature regime of the Indian Ocean has some peculiarities. In the northern part of the basin, two seasons are observed: a warm, dry, sunny winter and a hot, cloudy, rainy, stormy summer. Such seasonality depends on the influence of monsoons. High temperatures are typical for seas surrounded by hot deserts, for example, in the Red Sea, up to 34 degrees Celsius, in the Persian Gulf, up to 35.6 degrees Celsius. However, the average surface temperature of the Indian Ocean is lower than that of the Pacific Ocean and amounts to plus 17 degrees Celsius. The lower temperature is due to the strong cooling effect of Antarctic waters. On the other hand, the northern part of the ocean is the warmest, as it is well heated and lacks an inflow of cold waters. Currents in the Indian Ocean have a special character. Monsoons have the greatest influence on the currents of the northern part of the Indian Ocean. The wind changes the direction of surface water movement depending on the season. The northern part of the Indian Ocean is the only region of the world ocean with such a clear seasonal change of currents. The most powerful current on our planet, the west wind drift, passes through the ocean basin. The speed of the current depends on wind strength and varies by season. The maximum speed, 20 to 30 miles per day, is observed near Kerguelen Island. The Indian Ocean is also famous for its tides. The height of tides in some of its areas breaks all records. On average, it is just a couple or 3 meters, but near the coast of India, near Mumbai, it can reach 5 to 6 meters, and near Australia, near the city of Darwin, even 7 to 8 meters. In the Indian Ocean grow brown algae, the longest in the world. However, they can be found in many places, and they are abundant in the Sargasso Sea, which is located in the Atlantic Ocean. But we will talk about that when we look at the Atlantic Ocean. In the Indian Ocean, near Mauritius, there is a unique underwater waterfall. More precisely, it would be better to call it a sandfall, as it consists of sand that streams down the slope of an underwater mountain. It looks absolutely incredible. The underwater world of the Indian Ocean is fascinating, diverse, and bright. Its warm waters abound with a large number of exotic plants and animals, which allows the third largest ocean to be called the most populated water space. In the waters of the Indian Ocean, among the incredibly beautiful coral structures, lives a huge number of brightly colored fish, sponges, mollusks, crustaceans, crabs, worms, starfish, urchins, turtles, glowing anchovies, and sailfish. Dangerous species for humans are also found here: octopuses, jellyfish, poisonous sea snakes, and sharks. It is the Indian Ocean that accounts for the largest number of shark attacks on humans. However, this still happens extremely rarely, only a few cases a year. So dear subscribers, please don't increase this statistic. If you happen to swim in the waters of the Indian Ocean, in mangrove thickets lives the mudskipper, a fish that can spend a long time on land thanks to its special body structure. In the coastal waters, you can find sardinellas, mullets, jacks, sea catfish. In the southern part live ice fish, white-blooded fish. In the tropical zones, you can encounter rare and unusual members of the siren family, dugongs, and of course dolphins and whales. The largest ray, the manta ray, is also found in the Indian Ocean. Among birds, the most common are frigate birds and albatrosses. Among the endemics, the paradise flycatcher and the white-throated rail. On the southern coast of Africa and in Antarctica live penguins. Sometimes eyewitnesses have observed very strange phenomena on the ocean surface, glowing circles. This phenomenon has not yet been properly studied, but most likely it is caused by colonies of bioluminescent microorganisms, which have made the Indian Ocean their home. Did you know that scientists have discovered the birth of a new continent in the Indian Ocean? French and Australian geologists studied the composition of rocks in the southern part of the Indian Ocean and found that a new continent is forming there. Scientists conducted research on the Kerguelen Islands, which are located in the Indian Ocean not far from Antarctica. They show that granitic magma, continental crust, can form not only in subduction zones, but also in the middle of the ocean. This presumably is how continents are born. The authors proposed a hypothesis that the syenite massif of Kerguelen Island is, in essence, a continent embryo, which in millions of years will become a full-fledged landmass, and all we can do now is wait a bit. From the interesting facts about the Indian Ocean, an asteroid that killed the dinosaurs was found in the Indian Ocean. A huge mysterious basin located near modern-day India may be the largest crater in the history of our planet, formed by the collision of a large asteroid with Earth. A major meteorite fell into the Indian Ocean. Scientists from the University of Texas say that if their research is correct, this crater formed about 65 million years ago, and it may have caused the climate shift and dinosaur extinction, rather than the Chicxulub crater on the Yucatan Peninsula in Mexico. Today, the standard theory of dinosaur extinction is climate change caused by an asteroid hitting modern Mexico, but it turns out the dinosaurs were hit twice. Numerous transport routes pass through the Indian Ocean, but many are transit routes, beginning and ending outside the ocean itself. Shipping lanes in the Indian Ocean connect Europe and North America with the Middle East, Central and Far East, as well as Southeast Asia with Australia. In terms of shipping development, the Indian Ocean lags behind the Atlantic and Pacific Oceans, but it exceeds them in oil transport volumes, as the Persian Gulf is the world's main oil exporting region. Here is where the main flow of oil and petroleum products is concentrated, and this is the main environmental problem of the ocean. One of the main pollutants of the Indian Ocean is oil. It gets into the water due to accidents on coastal oil rigs and shipwrecks. In the Indian Ocean, more than in any other, rogue waves, also called killer waves or caprolas, are recorded. These are huge solitary waves, reaching heights of 15 to 20 meters. The highest chance of encountering them is near the coasts of Africa, in the western part of the ocean. It is reliably known that in June 1968, the American supertanker World Glory was sunk by a caprola, which broke it in two. The ship went to the bottom, taking 22 lives, and 49,000 tons of crude oil spilled into the sea. Everyone's heard stories about the Bermuda Triangle, but few know there is a similar area in the Indian Ocean, often called the Death Pocket. No anomalies have been discovered there, but many ships disappeared, and some were later found adrift without crews. Submarines and aircraft have also gone missing in the Death Pocket. Maybe it's pirates, maybe the Flying Dutchman, or maybe you have your own theory that no one else knows. But the fact remains that in 2004, an earthquake of magnitude 9.3 occurred in the Indian Ocean. Its death toll was about 300,000 people, with most victims perishing due to the tsunami triggered by the quake. To this day, it remains the most destructive tsunami in recorded history. And has anyone heard of black smokers and white smokers? But don't get the wrong idea. It's not what it sounds like. In rift valleys of the Red Sea, hydrothermal fields have been discovered. Here, seawater descends through cracks to great depths, heats up to more than 400 degrees Celsius, and becomes saturated with metal-bearing sediments containing iron and copper. Then, the water rises back up and seeps into the cold bottom waters, forming the so-called black smokers. And if the temperature is below 300 degrees Celsius, white smokers are formed. The mighty Indian Ocean truly boggles the imagination. This vast expanse of water stretching from horizon to horizon long frightened even the boldest sailors. Its depths are still not fully explored, and there's every reason to believe that many secrets remain hidden in its waters. But science does not stand still, and our knowledge grows year after year. after year, or from episode to episode, just like it does for our subscribers. And that's all for today. Subscribe, like, and share this video with your friends. It really helps us grow. This was Planet Earth. See you next time.